So update Red Skies has been out for a couple of weeks now, and I've taken the time to really fully understand the entirety of this new mechanic that is the Commander's View. And yes, it did take away just a few features from the already existing binos, though if you're someone like myself who likes to play in the higher tier environment, it did add a whole bunch of new features that really do make specific vehicles just either that much more unique and more desirable while at the same time making them just a little bit more deadlier. Now that's what we're going to go ahead and talk about in today's video. So before we go ahead and get started with the actual details of the commander sites themselves, I just want to let you guys know really quick that this only applies to PC users. So if you are on the consoles, the PlayStation or the Xbox, I'm really sorry guys, you are kind of out of luck when it comes to these certain keybinds. Now, moving forward with that, what you're seeing right here is the M1A2 Abrams, which does have the Commander View. Now, if we go ahead and go over to the control scheme, right here, all you have to do is just type in Commander or COM, just for short, and you'll see two control functions right here. Commander Fire Control and Commander Sight. Now, this Commander Fire Control is bound to my left control right mouse button, so basically that makes it so that I'm able to utilize the gun appropriately through the Commander View, while the Commander Sight just puts me in that Commander View or that CITV view if your vehicle does have it. Now, this is an extra key that I have on my current mouse. I also use the left control B button that would also engage it as well. The Commander View option is an incredible tool that allows you to utilize more of the battlefield, more so than you would ever find with the Bino View. Now, Binos by nature in this game only have a set view distance that is very, very slightly adjustable through the skill of your actual crew members themselves. However, with the brand new CITV, they offer a unique setup, much like how you would find with the actual gun themselves, but instead your commander actually views them. However, just because you have this brand new feature, it also comes with some decent trade-offs. One of the biggest trade-offs of having the brand new Commander View is that if you have a thermal sight or a CITV, it no longer applies to the binos. Instead, it is now attached directly to the Commander View. However, what that means in its entirety is that you have to expose a little piece of your vehicle in order to utilize that top-mounted optic, which does add a good sense of realism and something that I very much welcome into the game itself. However, it does limit your vehicle's capability just a little bit more, seeing that yes, you have to expose yourself. So if an HE frag round comes your way, you're pretty screwed for the most part, unless you're in a Russian tank, which doesn't really have a CITV to begin with. So here's a good example of exactly what I mean. Now, this is the Chally 2F, which as you can see right here does have an amazing field of view in its commander view. However, the moment I take a look at my opponent right here, he does knock out my optic, which means my optic is now disabled. It can still be utilized, I can still use it, I just can't move it and I can't really do anything else with it. So that means I have to pull back, repair the vehicle, and then go ahead and move back up into my position to be able to locate where the opponent might be. Now, the other negative downside of this is if your commander, for whatever reason, gets killed or replaces any crew member in your vehicle, you lose the almost entirety of the commander view, especially if you have a thermal sight, and you can't utilize it anymore until he is replaced, effectively kind of taking away the efficiency of your vehicle, although that is not entirely a bad thing. It kind of puts you in a position where you kind of have to think about each and every one of your positionings, especially when it comes to using that Russian HE fragmentation round, which can be absolutely devastating. And even more so now because you have to expose the entirety of your crew. However, there are some really good sides that thankfully did stick around, especially in this update. Let me go ahead and show you exactly what I mean when I say there's some pretty good features that did stick around. Now, this is my, of course, commander view, as you saw earlier, and this is my regular bino view. Thankfully, if you do go ahead and click your attack button or machine gun button, the turret will still traverse exactly to where you're looking inside your bino view. So if you're someone who likes to shoot over bushes or hills like myself and use the bino view, you can still use it, thankfully, and you are still able to utilize the laser rangefinder or the rangefinder, if it does have the FCS, to be able to automatically set your gun's positioning and shot, and there you go right there. As you can see, it works just fine, and that's a good feature that I'm very glad Gaijin decided to leave in the game. Oh, and as you did see in the actual thumbnail itself, the STRV-122B PLSS does have that commander view, and the entire optic can actually move and look like a turning face. It's actually pretty funny, and I've seen players use it to some pretty hilarious effect. So the next thing I want to go ahead and touch on is the commander aim mode. So what this means is that you no longer have to rely on your gunner to be able to utilize your primary weapon, which is the cannon, the auto cannon, machine gun, etc. But not every single vehicle in the game does have this feature. Now, this is more or less for the more modern vehicles or more higher-end vehicles that I think span from the 70s and 80s all the way above that, maybe a little bit sooner too. But what I mean by that is instead of going into each and every single game to find out which vehicle has this mode, all you have to do is go into your X-ray view, make sure your armor parts is disabled here, and helps you out a ton, and just hover over your commander, and you can see right there, commander can fire main armament. Here's another good example of where that just doesn't really exist. If I take a look at, say, the Tiger II, I'll find the commander somewhere over here, and you can see right there, he does not have the can commander, well, can fire the main gun. Going back to, say, the Russians, which even they do have as well, can fire the main armament. Another good giveaway from that, too, is if you ever see this. Now, this is another improvement, too. Commander optics. You can take a look at the zoom, sight FOV of 14, etc., etc. If we take a look at the Americans, you can see right here, 2 to 8. Now, this one, this is going to make you guys really like what I'm going to show you next. If we go ahead and, say, take a look at the Merkava Mark IIB or the Mark I, you can see that it has a commander view, but check out those optics. 4 times to 20 times zoom, whereas the main gun only has 8 times. That is incredibly efficient, and it does also have the commander fire aim. Again, not every single vehicle has these features. Oh, and also the BMP-2M also has that exact same feature. There's the gunner optic. There's the commander optic. So you can use those missiles with that commander sight. Did you know that? Because he can't fire it too. It's pretty nuts, isn't it? So there it is. That is all you need to know when it comes to the commander view. Now, ultimately, at the end of this, it comes down to you, the actual player, how to utilize it, when to use it, and how to become incredibly efficient. Remember, repetition is absolutely key, especially when it comes to utilizing, well, the new key set or the new keybinds. And yes, I know, it did add a couple new keybinds, which is kind of annoying to be honest, but let's be honest here. This adds more realism into the game, which is very much welcome. Sure, it did take away some efficiency from using binos, staying behind full cover, etc. However, now you have a more realistic appeal when it comes to each and every one of these vehicles that you are playing, while at the same time, being able to take away other players' ability as well as their advantage over you. If, say, you don't have a commander independent thermal viewer and they do, all you have to do is knock out their commander or just knock out their sight and you level the playing field. And that's something that is definitely worth noting for sure. So with all of that being said, I hope you guys did enjoy everything. Let me know how I did. If you guys want to see more of this kind of stuff, feel free to let me know. And to those who made it to the end of the video, guys, thank you so much. I see the average viewer ship of the if each and every one of my videos. And it's a little sad to be honest, but it kind of is what it is, okay? So to those who stuck around for it, thank you guys so much. Give me a thumbs up if you did, thumbs down if you didn't like it. You guys know the whole spiel, okay? So with everything again being said, I'll see you guys not only in the next video or even the streams, which is always, you should definitely check out, but in War Thunder itself. Enjoy the new sights, ladies and gentlemen, and I'll see you in game.